there, Kingdom Builder kids, and welcome to worship today. I am so glad you decided to join us. I am Miss D, and we have such a jam-packed session ready for you this morning. We're going to sing, we're going to dance, we're going to play games, scripture memory, and of course, we're going to get into the Word of God and learn more about Jesus. Are you ready? Because I'm ready. It's This Way to KB. But I am especially excited because, as you can see, I have, well, you can't really see, it's just microphone. But anyway, I have a special guest today, and I'm excited to introduce her. Cassidy Terry is here. Cassidy, come on up. High five. How are you, my friend?
I'm good.
You are good. Thank you so much for coming. I appreciate you. Guys, I always get excited when people come and worship with me live and in person because I'm actually not only talking to a camera. So I am so glad you're here this morning. And guys, I have a secret. It's her birthday. It's her birthday today, and she came to hang out with me. And you know, I feel so special. You came here on your birthday. Thank you so much. But you know what we gotta do, right? We're gonna have to sing happy birthday to you. So, can you guys help me sing happy birthday to Cassidy? All right, real quick, ready? One, two, three. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Cassidy. Why are you looking at me like that? Happy birthday to you. All right, tell us, how old are you this morning?
I'm 10.
10 years old, double digits. All right, well done. Well done, well done. Well, happy birthday, my friend. Thank you so much for coming. It's going to be exciting. It's going to be fun. We have fun game for you guys today, a great lesson, some praise and worship where you're going to see me try to dance, and we all know I don't dance, but it's going to be great. But we're going to start off with confessions. And Cassidy, I'm going to put you on the spot. Tell me, why do we confess? Why is it important for us to confess? What do you think?
Because what we confess, oh boy.
It's okay.
What we confess?
Yeah, exactly. We can have whatever we say. The Bible says that when we confess good things about ourselves, then that means good things are going to happen, right? Yes. So I don't know about you. I need some good things to happen to me, so that's why we confess. Does that sound pretty much right to you?
Yeah.
All right, cool. All right, so we're going to go ahead and get into our confession. We're going to start off with I love God. Are you guys ready? If you're seated, go ahead and stand up and repeat after me. Say, I love God.
I love God.
I love the Lord Jesus Christ.
I love the Lord Jesus Christ.
The blessed Holy Spirit.
The blessed Holy Spirit.
The things of the Spirit.
The things of the Spirit.
The Word of God.
The Word of God.
The work of God.
The work of God.
And the people of God.
And the people of God.
Better than I love.
Better than I love.
Anything else.
Anything else.
In all this world.
In all this world.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
All right, we're going to put on the armor of God this morning. And I know some of you guys are a little bit salty. We're not singing the armor of God song. But just wait for praise and worship. I think you'll be pleasantly surprised. Okay, you ready? Armor of God. I put on the whole armor of God.
I put on the whole armor of God.
So I can stand against the devil's scheme.
So I can stand against the devil's scheme.
The helmet of salvation.
The helmet of salvation.
The shoes of peace. The belt of truth.
The belt of truth.
The breastplate of righteousness.
The breastplate of righteousness.
The shield of faith.
The shield of faith.
And the sword of the Spirit.
And the sword of Spirit.
Which is the Word of God.
Which is the Word of God.
And I will use the Word.
And I will use the Word.
To knock down.
To knock down.
To crush.
To crush.
And to stop.
And to stop.
Anything. anything,
anything
that is not of God.
That is not of God.
All right, nice and loud, let's say it together. Say, I'm a winner.
I am a winner.
Born to be a leader.
Born to be a leader.
To set those captives free.
To set the captains free.
There you go. And lead men.
And lead men.
In the path of righteousness.
In the path of righteousness.
For his name's sake.
For his name's sake.
Why?
Because I'm a righteous seed.
Oh, because I'm a righteous seed. Go ahead and high five your neighbor. Give him an elbow five just for kicks. And say, good morning, righteous seed.
Good morning, righteous seed.
Ah, there you go. Okay, guys, are you guys ready for praise and worship this morning? We have some of our favorites today. Go, Great Commission, one of my favorites. So we're going to go ahead and start off with this one. All right. Are you ready to go? Are you ready to go? I'm ready.
Green light, go pedals on the right, step on the gas, go fast, baptize and make disciples.
Go on your skateboard.
Go on your skateboard.
Go on your surfboard.
Go on your surfboard.
Big fat board.
Go in your big fat board, baptize and make disciples.
What's your name?
Matthew 28, 19 and 20, that's the Great Commission. Matthew 28,
oh, 19
and 20, says to go so fishing. Matthew 28, 19 and 20, that's the Great Commission. Matthew 28, 19 and 20, says to go, 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 go.
Go
and make disciples of every nation, baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go and teach them to observe all I've commanded, and I'll be with you till the end of the age.
You got the green light?
You've got the green light. Go pedals on the right. Step on the gas, go fast. Baptize and make disciples.
Go on your surf.
Go on your skateboard.
Skateboard, sorry.
Go in your big fat board.
Burn rubber.
Burn rubber for the Lord. Baptize and make disciples. Matthew 28, 19 and 20. That's the Great Commission. Matthew 28,
oh,
19
fishing.
And 20. Says to go so fishing. That's the Great Commission. Matthew 28, 19 and 20 says to go, 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 go.
All right. Well done, well done, well done. I love that song. It's so fun, and it's a reminder for us that wherever we go, we're supposed to tell others about Jesus. All right. Our second song is Armor of God. Are you ready? See, Cassidy gave us an Armor of God video, and it was so good that we're going to do it here. Here we go.
Are you ready?
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 salvation. Sword of the Spirit.
Oh, all right, I made it. I made it through. All right, here we go.
Be strong in the Lord and his mighty power. The strength takes care of you when life's sour. Put on the armor of God and fight the enemy. Can you tell me now
all the pieces you need?
Be strong in the Lord and his mighty power. The strength takes care of you when life's sour. Shoes of peace, shield of faith, helmet of salvation, sword of the
I
spirit.
I got the helmet, guys.
Helmet of salvation,
I'm good.
Sword of the spirit.
I hope y'all were watching Cassidy, because if you're watching me, you might have been confused. However, that was a blast. That's fun. That song is super awesome, and it's just a reminder of how important it is for us to put on our armor each and every day. All right, so we're going to wind it down just a little bit and sing How Great Is Our God. He is a great, great God. Amen.
How great is our God. Sing with me, how great is our God, and all will see how great is our God.
How great?
How great is our God.
Amen, amen, amen. Thank you guys so much for worshiping with me. Cassidy, thank you so much. We're going to call you back in just a few minutes, but you can take your seat for just a little bit. Take a breather, maybe get some water after all that dancing. But yeah, I love worshiping with you guys. I love that we can come together and sing about the goodness of God. Amen. Amen. All right, so we're going to switch gears just a little bit, and we're going to do our announcements. It is announcement time, and first and foremost, we want you to give yourself a hand. Go ahead and clap for yourself. Pat yourself off in the back. You are here. You are worshiping, so well done. All right. So today, for our scripture memory time, one of the most important times that we have, because we want to make sure that we hide the word of God in our hearts. And, you know, incidentally, that is my memory verse for today. It is Psalm 119, verse 1, which is our theme verse for here for KB. And it says, your word have I hidden in my heart that I might not sin against you. Do you know what that means? That means if we know what's in the word of God and we know what God is asking for us to do, then we don't do things that we're not supposed to do. Like, if you know the rules in your house, you will follow the rules so you don't get in trouble, right? If we know what God is asking us to do and we follow those, then we will not get into trouble. So that is our scripture for today, Psalm 119, verse 1. We're going to learn it together, and I challenge you guys, go ahead and learn this at home. And as always, I love getting videos from you guys because it shows me that, A, you're engaged, and B, I just miss you. So I love getting videos from you guys, okay? So we're going to learn Psalm 119, verse 1 today, okay? So we're going to say, your word, we're going to have a book for the Bible. Your word have I hidden in my heart that I might not sin against you. Okay? So pretty simple. Okay? Psalm 119, verse 1. One more time. Your word have I hidden in my heart that I might not sin against you. Okay? Psalm 119, verse 1. So go ahead and memorize that. It's a great scripture, and it's our theme for here for Kingdom Builders Children's Ministry. Okay, and today, guess what? We have a special treat. We have a highlight from one of our fourth and fifth grade super church teachers, Mr. Benson. He is going to share with you a scripture that he has been learning. Okay, Mr. Benson, take it away.
Good morning, KB children. I am Mr. Benson. And I want to give you a scripture of God's promises, especially during these challenging times. Jesus tells us in the book of John, chapter 16, verse 23, and when the time comes, you will ask nothing of me. You will need to ask me no questions. I assure you, most solemnly I tell you, that my Father will grant you whatever you ask in my name. So take all your requests directly to God and be blessed.
Oh, wow. Thank you so much, Mr. Benson. It was great to see you. I know your students were happy to see you. I was happy to see you. Thank you so much for taking the time and sending a scripture to us. I love it. I love hearing from the teachers. And kids, it just reminds you that scripture memory is not just for kids. Us as adults, we also need to memorize the word of God. Amen? Amen. All right. So sadly, guess what? VBS is over. Oh, VBS is over. But I hope you guys had so much fun. I had a blast. I love seeing you guys on our Zoom Imagination Station and Craft Times. I loved, even though I was the one, you know, putting together the VBS, I love seeing it all together and hearing people's reactions to it. I love seeing the videos and the pictures that your parents sit in. So thank you guys so much for attending. Thank you guys so much for encouraging us. Thank you to all of those who helped put it together. It was fantastic. It wasn't our original idea to do it in our homes, but it worked out so well. So I hope you guys had a lot of fun, because I also had a lot of fun. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and get to our offering time. So if you have offering today, you can ask your parents to text to give, and they can use the code KB, and it will go to the children's ministry, okay? All right, so let's go ahead and say our confessions. Say, Father, I thank you as we obey your word in giving and receiving. I thank you that all our needs are met and that we are blessed to be a blessing to your people. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. All right, guys. So we are back, and it is a lesson time. It is lesson time. But because I have a friend here today, Cassidy, I'm going to call you back up, and you're going to participate. It's going to be an interactive lesson today. So go ahead and come back up. Yeah, you recovered from Armor of God? You're good? All right, she's good. All right, she's young. She's fine. All right, so before we get into our lesson, I got to ask you, Did you attend virtual VBS this year?
Yes.
Yes? Okay. What was your favorite part?
I would have to say my favorite part is when Dr. Natalie shows us our choo-choo snacks.
Ah, choo-choo snacks. You know what? The whole time everyone kept asking, what is a virtual snack? What is a virtual snack? Now we know virtual snacks are snacks that we do at home together, and it was fantastic. So I agree. My favorite snack, I think, was the, I love Rice Krispie Treats. Marshmallows are my favorite.
You didn't do that one?
Oh, no.
I'll try it.
Okay, all right. It's still on the website, so you know what? Thank you for letting me know. It is on the website, so if you didn't get a chance to do any of the snacks, or you can just watch it back and do it all over again, it is on the website, so make sure you go do that because that was my favorite. I love Rice Krispie Treats. Okay, but I'm glad you had a lot of fun. I'm glad you enjoyed because, well, we're doing it for you guys. Okay, so today, our lesson is about time and using our time wisely. Now, yes, last week we talked about Jehoshaphat, and we talked about how he prayed to God and God delivered him in a mighty, mighty way. And now we're talking about another story with Joshua and how God delivered his children again in a mighty way. But we're talking about time. So here I have a clock. Okay. This is an analog clock. Now I know some of you guys don't know how to tell time on these clocks because, you know, we have all these gadgets and stuff. But yeah, so this is an analog clock, which means that it has all your numbers and it goes around in seconds and seconds. And this, like if you have a phone or a gadget, is your digital clock. So we have analog and digital. Now, have you ever heard of daylight savings?
Yes.
Yes. So daylight savings. So in the fall, we fall back, which means we get an extra hour, which is yay, more sleep. And in the spring, we spring forward, which means we lose an hour and we're all coming to church blurry-eyed. Okay?
Yeah.
But if you have an analog clock, guess what? You might be late if you forget to change the clock before. It's like 2 a.m. So if you don't change the clock before midnight or before you go to sleep, when you wake up in the morning, you're going to be an hour behind. Okay? You're going to be an hour behind. But if you have a phone, like this phone, it automatically does it. So I can just go to sleep whenever I want to. I wake up and I'm like, oh, look, it's 7 a.m. And it really is 7 a.m., not 8 a.m. or 6 a.m. or whatever.
Right.
So we're talking about using our time wisely. And if we have Jesus on our side, and if Jesus is helping us, then we can live like we're in a digital age and we don't have to worry about anything. We don't have to worry about time because it's already going to be done for us. So our story today is about Joshua and how he was fighting against some enemies. But before we get to that, summertime. It's summertime, right?
Mm-hmm.
You ready to go back to school?
Definitely.
Definitely ready to go back to school?
Okay. Yes, never thought that I would say that.
You never thought you know what? I'm with you. I am with you. So it's been a little rough, right? We left school early. A lot of digital learning, a lot of paperwork, not seeing our friends, a lot of staying inside. So we've had a lot of time. What have you done? What are some of the things you've done this summer or during quarantine or anything? What can you think of that you've done? Because you've had a lot of time, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I've just been using things for me to, like, help make the days go faster. So
okay.
I have a schedule.
Okay. Nice.
I wake up at 8 o'clock.
Okay.
At 8:15, I do my devotion and
nice.
My confession.
Very nice.
At 9 a.m., I brush my teeth and everything, and I practice my multiplication.
Okay.
And then...
Wait, can we eat?
Yeah, I eat.
Oh, okay, we eat. Okay, I just want to make sure we ate in there because I'm hungry just listening to you. So, okay,
yeah.
We ate. All right, we ate.
Sorry,
okay,
I
go ahead.
We eat, and then I... brush my teeth and I put my clothes on.
Mm-hmm.
And then at 9 a.m. I do my multiplication for 20 minutes.
Nice.
And then
What's
25.
I got you there. All right, go ahead. Sorry. Okay, go ahead.
And then I have a 2 hour and 30 minute TV break.
Nice.
Depending if I'm on time.
Oh, okay. That's a good break. Okay.
Yeah.
What's your favorite TV show?
The Proud Family.
Oh, she likes it old school. I love that show. So great. Okay, go ahead.
And then I read for 30 minutes.
Okay.
I do my summary.
Okay.
And then I do my division.
So you're keeping busy. It sounds like you're keeping pretty busy, which is good. I mean, one of the ways that we can manage our time is to make sure we're doing things that are productive. So it sounds like you're being super productive and you're not just sleeping all day and, you know, watching TV. I like that you have TV time, but it's not all day. Some of us are on our gadgets all day, every day, and that's never good. So for me, my time is, you know, filled with work and all these kind of things, but it's just so important that we've had so much time with family. Like, I've enjoyed getting to know my family better. I've enjoyed getting to know my nephews. They're getting big, and, you know, they talk, and they play, and they're fun. I have three teenage girls at home. I'm having, you know, having fun getting to know them. So it's just a lot of fun utilizing our time well, but it's time to go back to school, right?
Yes, yeah, it's time definitely.
To go back to school. So, yeah. So, okay, so we're talking about time today, and if you had an extra hour in your day, what did you think you would do with it?
I would probably use it to maybe like possibly I would use it to just maybe like do something with my family.
Okay.
Like playing games like Uno or Phase 10.
Okay.
Watching a movie, eating popcorn together.
Just spending time together.
Right.
Yeah. I mean, that's one of the things I would probably do. I think I do so many things throughout the day that by the end of the day, I'm like, oh, I didn't even talk to anybody today. I just, you know, kind of saw them. We're in the same house, but, you know, going back and forth. So I agree with you. If I had an extra hour in the day, I would spend more time with family. Okay, so our Bible story today is Joshua. And they had these neighboring country called the Gibeonites. Now, the Gibeonites were their allies, which means they were their friends, and the Israelites were going to help the Gibeonites because some armies were coming against Gibeon. And so the Israelites went to help Gibeon fight this army. And so when they went there, they were winning against the army. So they're winning, they're beating them, and then all of a sudden, the sun's going down. They're like, oh no, the sun's going to go down. We're going to have to stop. But we were winning. You know, sometimes like you're in a really good book or you're playing a game or you're doing something really fun and it's your mom's like, oh, it's bedtime. Does that make you happy? You're like, no, I just need one more hour. Oh, just 30 more minutes, 20 more minutes. And you start negotiating, right? Yeah.
I don't negotiate.
You don't negotiate?
I just do what I have to do.
Okay, well, you just do what you got to do. I appreciate that. See, when I was growing up, I used to try to negotiate. Can I get 10 more minutes, 15 more minutes, 20 more minutes? Just, you know, a little bit more time. So Joshua, he prayed to God and he said, God, can you stop the time so we can finish this battle? And you know what God did?
What?
He made the sun stand still for 24 hours. That means it never got dark. The sun never went down. It just stood there. And it was like daylight for like over 24 hours. Yeah. And they were able to fight the enemy. They were able to defeat them. They were able to win the battle because God made the sun stand still. Now, that's never happened before. And it's never happened since, and I'm pretty sure it'll never happen again. But it was amazing because Joshua realized that time was so important, and he realized that the only way they were going to win this battle is if he prayed and he asked God for help. So being on God's team, I think it's pretty cool. So
I agree.
Today, I'm just encouraging guys. Sounds like you're using your time wisely. I use most of my time wisely, but, you know, sometimes in there, I find myself just sitting on the couch, just staring off into space, and so I'm going to work on that. But I'm encouraging all you guys, as we're getting ready to go back to school, whatever form it takes. I know some of you guys are going to be e-learning again. Some of you guys are going back. Some of you guys are a little bit of a hybrid. But whatever way you go back to school, it's important now to start working on your time so that, you know, you go to school, you do your schoolwork, you have some play time, get your homework done. Get your chores and all that stuff. So, time wisely. Sound good?
Yes.
All right, perfect. Okay, we're going to pause just for a second because it's time to play our game. And our game today is called Beat the Clock. And Cassidy is going to try to beat me and the clock, okay? I don't know how that's going to work. But what you need for this game is you need a stack of cups. If you have, we need 20 cups or as many cups as you have. If you don't have 20 cups, that's fine. But if you can have cups that are different colors, so you need one cup, one stack of 19, and then one stack, just one cup with a different color, okay? So go ahead and grab your cups. That's all you need today is some cups, and we'll be right back with our game. All right, you got 1 minute. are back. So, like I said, you needed a stack of cups, and I have 19 blue cups and one green cup here at the bottom. Cassidy has the same thing. So the goal of the game is, of course, with one hand, choose your hand, you're going to pick up one cup, put it down, and then you have to pick up the whole stack and put it on top. Okay, and you keep doing that until you get to, hopefully, the green cup is on top. So the goal is to have the green cup on top before the minute is out. Okay, so you have to unstack and restack as quick as you can. All right, so I'm gonna put my green on the bottom. I'm gonna stop cheating over here. All right, are you ready, Cassidy?
Yes.
All right, you guys ready? All right, when the timer starts, we're gonna go. One hand.
The game begins in 3, 2, 1.
Again, another time. I'm going to give you another chance. But good job. I hope you guys had a lot of fun with that. That was super fun for me. Okay. All right. All right. Good job. Good job. We recovered the cups. We're going to give you another try. Well done. All right. But we're going to go ahead and finish up with our lesson recap. All right. We're going to quiz Cassidy today. She did say she was ready to go back to school. We'll see how ready you are. Okay. Question number one. The army wanted to take the city of Gibeon by force. Is that true or false?
I'm going to say that is true.
True. Very good. That is true. The army wanted to fight the Gibeonites. And so, yes, that is true. I won't get into my second question. All right. So question number two. The Israelites helped the army destroy the city. They helped destroy the Gibeonites. True or false?
False.
That is false. Right. The Israelites helped them save their city, not destroy their city. Okay. Number three. You're 2 for 2. God told Joshua that the Israelites would be victorious in battle. They would win. True or false?
True.
True. Very good. So when Joshua prayed, he asked God, and God said that they would be victorious. Okay? All right. You are 3 for 3. Well done. You might be ready for school. Okay. Number four. God sent lightning bolts from heaven to strike the enemy. True or false?
False.
False. He did not send lightning bolts. But in the story, he did send hailstones, okay? All right, so last question, you are 4 for 4. If you get this one right, you are truly ready to go back to school. Okay, number five, God stopped the sun in the sky until the Israelites won the battle. True or false?
That is true.
True, very good. He stopped the sky for 24 hours. It was just light outside. I mean, can you imagine? 2 o'clock in the morning, the sun is still up. Midnight, the sun is still up. 5 o'clock, the sun is still up. Crazy, crazy, crazy. All right, good job, Cassidy. High five. Well done. Did you have fun today?
Yes.
I am glad you had fun. Thank you so much for coming. Thank you guys for watching. We love worshiping with you each and every day. I'm going to pray, and then Cassidy, we're going to say bye to the people. Is that cool?
Yes.
All right, let's pray. Father, we thank you for this time that we've had together today. Thank you for the fun that we had. Thank you for Cassidy being able to come and worship with me today. Thank you for her 10th birthday. I thank you that you bless her and give her many more birthdays to come. We thank you as we go throughout this week that you bless us and keep us safe until we meet again. We love you and we thank you for loving us. In Jesus' name,
amen.
All right, guys, I love you. I miss you. I cannot wait to see you. Cassidy, you're going to help me say it, but we're going to say bye for now.